Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvandi. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. This is lecture number 9 on Internal Combustion Engine. The topic is Combustion in SI Engine. We recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we studied about the fuel and fuel supply system in the SI engine, the various fuels, fuel rating, calorific value of the fuel, and the fuel supply system. The main component in the fuel supply system is carburetor, and we studied about the ignition system, that is magneto ignition system and the battery ignition system. In the SI engine or petrol engine, the air fuel mixture is drawn into the engine cylinder during the suction stroke, and using a spark plug and the ignition system, an electric spark is produced at the end of the compression stroke. So the electric spark will initiate the combustion, that is ignition. So ignition is initiating the combustion, and the combustion begins, and the air fuel mixture, the fuel burns inside the engine cylinder. And how the combustion is taking place inside the combustion chamber of SI engine, that is what we are going to study here. And the different stages of combustion, flame front propagation, normal and abnormal combustion, combustion chamber in the SI engine, these are all the topics we are going to discuss in this lecture. The learning outcome to this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the students will be able to explain the stages of combustion in the SI engine, and the students will be able to discuss the factors influencing the flame speed in the SI engine combustion, and they will describe the normal and abnormal combustion. They will define what is knocking in the SI engine and draw the diagram of combustion chamber in SI engine. These are all the learning outcome for the students. The combustion in the SI engine. So we try to explain with the help of the pressure crank angle diagram. So this is the pressure in the Y axis, and we have the crank angle in the X axis, 0 degree crank angle, 180 degree crank angle, and 360 degree crank angle. That is one revolution of the crank. And the compression, actually the 0 degree, so 180 degree is the top dead center. So 0 degree is the bottom dead center. 360 degrees also bottom dead center. So the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. The operation, the process is compression. The air fuel mixture inside the engine cylinder is compressed to a higher pressure. So AB is the compression process where the pressure is increasing. Theoretically, at the end of the compression stroke, at the point B, an electric spark is produced and the combustion is taking place when the piston is at the top dead center at constant volume. So because of the combustion, there is a steep increase in the pressure. So B to C, there is increase in pressure due to the combustion. And now from 180 degree from the top dead center, the piston starts to move towards the bottom dead center. So the expansion is taking place. So the first stroke, 0 to 180 compression stroke, and B to C is the combustion process, and C to D is the expansion process. The hot gases produced by combustion, they are expanding and producing power. So this is what theoretical P theta diagram for the combustion in the SI engine. But the actual diagram is deviating from the theoretical diagram. We will see the stages of combustion in the SI engine. So the actual diagram that we are going to draw, this is the actual diagram. Again, the pressure in the pressure in the Y axis in the bar, and the crank angle in the X axis. We have 0 degree, which is the top dead center, and on the left side of the 0 degree, that is what the before TDC. On the right side of the 0 degree or TDC, that is what the after TDC. So before TDC, it is compression process. After TDC, it is combustion and expansion process. And we divide the entire diagram in three stages: stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Stage 1 is ignition lag period, stage 2 is propagation of flame period, and stage 3 is afterburning period. So here we have three stages of combustion in the SI engine: stage 1, ignition lag period A to B, Stage 2, flame propagation period B to C, and stage 3, after burning stage, that is C to D. So, the 3, A to B is the ignition lag, B to C, that is the flame propagation period, and C to D, it is the after burning stage. Now, what is happening? When the piston is moving from the bottom dead center towards the top dead center, there is an increase in the pressure. So, we start from 70 degree crank angle, there is increase in pressure of the air fuel mixture. And here the spark is produced. So it is after 20 degree, that is somewhere at 15 degree before top dead center. So 15 degree before top dead center, A is the point. At A, the spark is produced. So the spark is produced in A, but the combustion is not initial, ignition is not happening. So, A to B, that is called ignition lag period. So, during this, so in the ignition lag period, it is called as preparation phase. So, during which growth and development of self-propagating nucleus of flames takes place. So, it is the mixer is getting up, air and fuel mixer is properly mixed, and the spark will initiate, it will promote the self-propagating nucleus of the flame takes place. Then this is the chemical process period, depends on both the temperature, pressure and nature of the fuel and proportion of the exhaust gas, exhaust residual gases. So the time gap between A to B depends on the temperature and pressure of the air fuel mixer, nature of the fuel and proportion of the exhaust residual gas. What is the source of exhaust residual gas? So, the cyclic operation of the engine cylinder, when the first cycle is completed, so there is a small space above the piston surface that is called as clearance space. So, in the clearance space, there is small amount of residual gases, exhaust gases present in the engine cylinder. During the next suction stroke, so the exhaust gases will mix up with the fresh air fuel mixer. So, exhaust gas, they are at a higher temperature. The fresh air fuel mixture, they are coming with atmospheric temperature with the engine operating condition. So, immediately it is getting mixed with the exhaust residual gases so that the temperature of the incoming air fuel mixture will increase. So, the exhaust gas that is increasing the temperature, at the same time, more amount of exhaust gas is not desirable for engine operation. So, we have to regulate the exhaust gas in the design of the engine. We have to regulate the exhaust gas present in the combustion chamber. So A to B is the preparatory phase. So during which there is no combustion, it is called as ignition lag period. And here the flame starts. So the combustion starts at the B. So immediately if we find there is a rise in the pressure, the steep rise in the pressure up to C. That is what? Propagation of flame. And from B, there is another line called the motoring line. So, this motoring line, when there is no combustion, this is what the pressure drop. So, the pressure drop will take place without combustion. When you rotate the crank, when the piston is descending, moving downward, that is called as motoring curve. That is one kind of test used in the performance of engine. Motoring test is there to calculate the friction power. We will see later. Now, the stage 2, it is a flame propagation period, during which the flame spreads throughout the combustion chamber. That is very important. It should quickly catch fire and the flame should quickly move across the combustion chamber and burn all the air fuel mixture available inside the combustion chamber. The flame propagates at a constant velocity. The heat release rate depends on the intensity of turbulence and the reaction rate, which depends on the mixer composition. There are two parameters important for the flame speed second stage. One is turbulence and the reaction rate. So reaction rate depends on the mixer composition. Mixer composition means the air fuel ratio, whether it is rich fuel ratio or lean air fuel mixer, that is the reason. So reaction rate and turbulence, they are important for the second stage. So higher the turbulence, higher the reaction rate, the time required for stage 2 will reduce. So, quickly all the gases are burnt inside the engine cylinder. And the stage 3, it is after burning stage, the flame velocity decreases. So, because here the amount of air fuel mixture present in the engine cylinder after this, the amount of the air fuel mixture available will be less. So, the amount of heat release will be less and the combustion rate becomes low. Due to the flame, lower flame velocity, and reduced to flame front surface. Since the expansion stroke starts before the stage of combustion, the piston moves moving away from the TDC, there can be no pressure rise during this phase. So in the stage 3, there is no pressure rise, but still there is small quantity of combustion taking place with the remaining portion of the air fuel mixture. And the flame front propagation. So the second stage, we said one parameter called flame front propagation. How the flame is propagating inside the combustion chamber. How the flame is moving across the combustion chamber in the SI engine. That is very important for releasing heat energy quickly, so that we will get more amount of work output from the engine. For efficient combustion, the rate of propagation of the flame front within the cylinder is quite critical. So this is, there are two important factors which determine the rate of movement of the flame front across the combustion chamber. They are reaction rate and the transposition rate. So there are two factors which are important which determines the flame front propagation. They are the reaction rate and the transposition rate. So what is reaction rate? Reaction rate is a result of purely chemical combination process in which the flames yields its way into the unburnt charge. To understand this, we take this diagram. Here you take this diagram. This is the combustion chamber. So the cross section of the combustion chamber, we have the air fuel mixture inside the combustion chamber. So here we have the spark plug, the spark is produced. So we divide the entire combustion chamber in different segments. So first segment, second segment, we have number of segments. In each segment, we have the unburnt air fuel mixture. When the spark is produced here, the burning is taking place in this area. So the gas here is heated up and the temperature of the gas is increasing and the gas is expanding. When the burnt gases pressure increases and they are expanding, the remaining portion, so they are moving in the towards D, that is the unburnt charge, it is getting compressed. When the unburnt charge is getting compressed, so the temperature will increase. So the reaction rate, the reaction rate is how the flame front is moving. So you look at here how it is defined. The reaction rate is result of purely chemical combination process in which the flame eats its way into the unburnt charge. How the flame is moving across the combustion chamber, that is what the reaction rate. And the transposition rate is due to the physical movement of the flame front related to the cylinder wall, and it also result of pressure differential setup between burning and unburnt in the combustion chamber. And burning, actually there is a burning gas on the left side, unburnt gas on the right side. So the pressure difference, it causes the transposition rate, how the flame is traveling across the combustion chamber. So the various factors influencing the flame speed. So the flame speed, the second stage is very crucial in the SI engine combustion. So the flame front propagation, that is very important, and they are influenced by turbulence, fuel air ratio, temperature and pressure of the incoming air fuel mixture, compression ratio, engine output, engine speed. So in all the the flame should move, it will travel at a higher speed. So the turbulence is the first factor. Turbulence, so how we define turbulence? Turbulence is a swell produced in the combustion chamber which improves the proper mixing of air and the fuel. The swirl movement, so the circulatory movement of the air fuel mixture. So in the design of the combustion chamber itself, we make the air fuel mixture to swirl inside the combustion chamber. So in the combustion chamber, many minute swirls are preferred than larger swirl. So we want minute swirl, smaller number of minute swirl, so that it will improve the mixing of air and the fuel. The turbulence in the combustion chamber increases the heat flow to the cylinder wall, accelerate the chemical reaction, and the combustion duration is minimized, which reduces the tendency of abnormal combustion. So the turbulence is very important, so which is promoting the heat flow to the cylinder wall. It is increasing the heat flow to the cylinder wall, accelerate the chemical reaction, and reduces the tendency of abnormal combustion, and we require turbulence inside the combustion chamber of SI engine. And the fuel air ratio, the fuel air ratio has a very significant influence on the flame speed. highest flame velocity are obtained with a somewhat richer mixer. So actually we somewhat richer mixer. So the 15:1 is the air fuel ratio we find. So we want little more fuel in the combustion chamber. So less thermal energy is released in the case of lean mixers, resulting lower flame temperature, and a very rich mixer leads to incomplete combustion, which results again in the release of lesser thermal energy. So very lean mixer or a very rich mixer, they are not preferred. We want somewhat richer mixer for better flame front propagation inside the engine cylinder. So temperature pressure of the incoming air fuel mixer. So the flame speed increases with increase in intake pressure and temperature. So this is possible because an overall increase in density of the charge. So density of the air fuel mixer, the fresh charge should be higher in the case of higher temperature and pressure. And the compression ratio, higher the compression ratio, the flame speed will increase. So compression ratio increases, the flame should increase. Temperature of the air fuel mixer is increasing, the flame speed is increasing. Richer mixer, the flame speed is increasing. Higher turbulence, the flame speed is increasing. These are all the parameters which will improve, which will increase the flame speed and the engine output. When the engine output increasing, flame speed increases. When the engine speed increases, flame speed increases. So all these parameters, engine output, engine speed, intake temperature, compression ratio, the higher fuel air ratio or air fuel ratio or turbulence, everything should be increased to increase to reduce the flame speed movement and to improve the combustion reaction rate. That is what important in the case of SI engine combustion. And we studied about the normal and abnormal combustion. This is what normal combustion. So the flame front is formed here at the point A, the spark is produced, and the flame front is moving in this direction, and it reaches the other side of the combustion chamber. This is what the normal combustion. And look at the P theta diagram. So the compression, so here the ignition takes place, and there is a pressure rise. The peak pressure is occurring after 20 degree, somewhere around 20 degree after TDC, and then the power stroke is obtained. This is the normal combustion. Now look at here. So this is abnormal combustion. So what is abnormal combustion? On the right hand side, if you find there is pressure fluctuation. Why the pressure fluctuation is occurring? So we will explain with this diagram. So again, this is again the cross section of the engine cylinder. So A is the point where the combustion is started. The spark is produced and the combustion is taking place. And the flame front is formed here, and the flame front is moving from A to D. So as I told earlier, so there are different segments inside the combustion chamber. Each segment has got some unburnt charge. So as the flame is moving, so the unburnt charge temperature is increasing, they are getting compressed. So the temperature is increasing in this direction. Now somewhere here at the point D, because of the higher temperature, there is a flame, auto ignition is formed. So there is auto ignition on its own because of higher temperature, and there is another flame front formed here, and this flame is moving in the opposite direction. Already there is a flame from A to D. Now it here at D there is a flame front, and this flame is moving from the right side to left side, and these two will collide, and there will be pressure fluctuation. The pressure fluctuation that gives this kind of fluctuation, that is called as the knocking or detonation in the SI engine. If the temperature of the unburnt mixer exceeds the self-ignition temperature of the fuel during the period of pre-flame reaction, spontaneous ignition or auto-ignition occur at various pin points. So here we find the auto-ignition or the spontaneous ignition. This phenomena is called as knocking. The spontaneous ignition is called as knocking, and the process of auto-ignition leads towards the engine knock. There will be vibration, pressure fluctuation, and this pressure fluctuation leads to vibration of the engine cylinder or engine setup. And the abnormal combustion causes the loss of power and mechanical damage to the engine. So this is this is not a desirable parameter, desirable phenomena in the case of SI engine combustion. So knocking should not occur in the SI engine combustion. So the effect of engine variable on the knock. there are three parameters which are all governing the knocking tendency in the SI engine. One is density factor, time factor, and the composition factor. So we will explain one by one. First, the composition factor. The composition of fuel like fuel air ratio and octane value are also influences the knocking tendency of the engine. So the fuel air ratio and octane value of the SI engine fuel, they are influencing knocking tendency. The flame speed, flame temperature, reaction time are different for different fuel air ratio. So that is, we have to be very careful. As we told earlier, the composition is the air fuel ratio. So somewhat richer air fuel ratio is desirable for the normal combustion and the quick travel of the flame across the combustion chamber. That you have to maintain, right? So when you have very high temperature or very high rich air fuel ratio, that will give the abnormal combustion inside the combustion chamber. Density factor. Any factor which reduces the temperature of the unburnt charge should reduce the possibility of knocking. So the knocking occurs because of higher temperature of the unburnt charge. So any factor which reduces the temperature of the unburnt charge should reduce the possibility of knocking. And any factor which reduces density of the unburnt charge should reduce the possibility of knocking. So the temperature and density of the unburnt charge, that is to be reduced. So these are all the factors. Increasing the compression ratio will increase the tendency of knocking. So when you increase the compression ratio, the knocking tendency will increase. Reduction in the mass of the charge inducted will reduce the tendency of knocking. So reduction, so actually the total quantity of air fuel mixture drawn inside, that is to be reduced. Increasing temperature of the mixer at inlet will increase the tendency of knocking. Very high temperature will leads to knocking. Hot spots in the combustion chamber wall should be avoided to reduce the tendency of knocking. What is hot spot? Some hot area in the combustion chamber wall because of the carbon deposits. Some deposits will be there, and the deposits, temperature of the deposit will be more, so that it will promote the auto ignition of the air fuel mixer. By retarding the spark timing from the optimized timing, the peak pressure are reached farther down on the power stroke and are thus far lower magnitude. So this might reduce the knocking. So retarding the spark will reduce the knocking. Retarding the spark will make the peak pressure to move away from the top dead center, so that it will reduce the knocking. A decrease in the output of the engine will reduce the tendency of knocking. So more the output in a smaller capacity, so smaller size of the engine, that will give the knocking. So decreasing the output of the engine will reduce the tendency of knocking. So the density factor. So density factor, any parameter which reduces the temperature of the unburnt charge and density of the unburnt charge will reduce the possibility of knocking in the engine cylinder. So these are all the parameter which will affect the knocking tendency in SI engine. So next is the time factor. Increasing the flame speed or reducing time of exposure of the unburnt mixer to auto ignition condition will tend to reduce the knocking. So increasing the flame speed. So that is what I am telling from the beginning. So the flame should travel inside the combustion chamber quickly from one end to another end, so that the speed of the flame should be higher, so that it will complete the combustion process in quick time, so that the possibility of auto ignition is reduced. So when the flame travel very slowly, so there is a possibility of auto ignition inside the combustion chamber. So increasing the flame speed reduces the tendency of knocking. An increase in the engine speed will increase the turbulence of the mixer, which will increase the flame speed. The knocking tendency is reduced by shortening the time required for the flame front to traverse combustion chamber. So engine size, combustion chamber size, and the spark plug position are the factor governing the flame travel distance. So the bigger the size of the SI engine, there is a possibility of knocking in the SI engine. So the size of the diameter and the stroke length should be smaller, and the combustion chamber size should be smaller, and the spark plug should be centrally located, so that the flame travel time will be reduced. Larger the engine size has a greater tendency for knocking. So size of the engine, diameter and stroke length is more, then it will give greater tendency for knocking. In order to have minimum flame travel, the spark plug is centrally located in the combustion chamber, resulting minimum knocking tendency. So increasing the flame speed, increasing the engine speed, and shortening the flame travel by smaller size of the engine, by locating the spark plug in the correct central position, these are the parameter in the time factor. So time factor means the time required for flame travel, flame speed, or flame travel across the combustion chamber should be minimum. So anything which will reduce the time of exposure, of the unburnt charge, will reduce the tendency of knocking in the SI engine. And the combustion chamber in the SI engine. So the design of combustion chamber for an SI engine has an important influence on the engine performance and its knocking tendency. So engine performance is how efficiently the fuel is burnt inside the combustion chamber, how effectively the power is produced by the engine. And knocking tendency is the unwanted parameter, unwanted phenomena in the combustion of the SI engine. The design involves the shape of the combustion chamber, location of the spark plug, and location of the inlet and the exhaust valve. So, what is the shape of the combustion chamber? Diameter, stroke length, the design, crown size, the piston crown size, everything, that is what the shape of the combustion chamber. Location of the spark plug and location of inlet and the exhaust valve. The important requirement of SI engine combustion chamber are to provide higher power output, higher thermal efficiency, and smooth engine operation. These are the parameters. The engine should produce higher power, higher thermal efficiency, and there will be a smooth engine operation. These are the parameters required, the parameter you have to consider in the design of the combustion chamber. So, smooth engine operation is achieved by reducing the possibility of knock, by reducing the distance of flame travel, by centrally locating the spark plug, satisfactory cooling of the spark plug point and the exhaust valve area, reducing the temperature of the last portion of the charge by transferring heat to the cylinder wall. So for smooth operation, there should not be knocking. For with operation of the engine without knocking, these are all the parameters. So reducing the distance of flame travel by centrally locating the spark plug, satisfactory cooling of the spark plug and the exhaust valve area, and reducing the temperature of the last portion of the charge by transferring heat to the cylinder wall. And the high power output and thermal efficiency achieved by high degree of turbulence in the combustion chamber. High volumetric efficiency, that is inducing more charge during the intake stroke, result in higher output. We have to draw more amount of air fuel mixture. Compact combustion chamber reduces the heat loss during the combustion and increases the thermal efficiency. So these are all the parameter for higher power output and higher thermal efficiency. And look at the combustion chambers used in the SI engine. We have different types of head, L head, T head, I head, and F head. So this is the T head. So this is the intake port, exhaust port. We have the spark plug here near the exhaust port, and the spark is produced and the flame travel across the combustion chamber. And the L size, L type head. So we have L type, so intake and exhaust port. So at the front side we have the intake port, on the rear side we have the exhaust port, and the spark plug here is centrally located, and this is the flame will travel quickly across the combustion chamber. This is again L head with the hemispherical shape at the cylinder head. This is again I head with again hemispherical shape at the cylinder head, and we have a curved surface on the piston crown. So spark plug is installed here, and we have intake valve, exhaust valve in the same line. So at the front we have the intake valve, on the rear side we have the exhaust valve. And this is F head, so we have the spark plug here, and the intake valve on the side, exhaust valve at the top, and the cylinder head is designed with some inclination. These are all the different types of combustion chambers used in the SI engines. And this is the computational fluid dynamics image of the combustion in the SI engine. So I will give more details about the computational CFD design of combustion in the SI engine later, just look at the image. This is the velocity. That means that indicates the velocity distribution inside the combustion chamber. That gives the picture about the turbulence inside the combustion chamber. This is the picture about the equivalence ratio, that is air-fuel ratio or fuel-air ratio inside the combustion chamber. And this is the temperature distribution inside the combustion chamber. This is the exhaust valve, this is the suction valve. So near the exhaust valve, you will find higher temperature. So we will study in just an image, so how the combustion taking place inside the combustion chamber. And we will study about, I will give more information about the modeling of combustion in the IC engine in the later lecture. And we stop here. So we have some questions to answer in the reflection spot. You can take a few seconds, some breathing time, and you try to answer the question. The first question, the auto ignition reaction time for spark ignition fuel increases with the richer mixer, increases with the weaker mixer. Auto ignition reaction time increases with the richer mixer, increases with the weaker mixer, is minimum for chemically correct mixer, all the above. So the correct answer is, so for auto ignition reaction time will increase with the leaner mixer. The knocking of the spark engine increases with increase in compression ratio, increase in inlet air temperature by increasing the cooling water temperature. So all the three parameter, increase in compression ratio, increase in intake temperature air, intake air temperature, and by increasing cooling water temperature, everything will improve the knocking tendency in the spark ignition engine. The knocking in the spark ignition engine gets reduced by retarding spark advance, by increasing the compression ratio, by increasing cooling water temperature, by increasing the inlet air temperature. How to reduce the spark intensity, spark knocking in the spark engine? By retarding the spark advance. The answer is by retarding the spark advance. Advancing the spark timing in the spark ignition engine increases the tendency of knocking, decreases the tendency of knocking, does not affect the knocking, none of the above. Advancing the sparking time, so that will increase the tendency of knocking. So what is advancing? Instead of 15 degree, we advance to 20 degree. That is what the advancing. Increasing the compression ratio in the spark ignition engine. Increase the tendency of knocking, decrease the tendency of knocking, does not affect the knocking, and none of the above. So increasing the compression ratio will increase the tendency of knocking. So when you increase the compression ratio, the pressure, pressure and temperature at the end of the compression will be more. So the more the temperature of the unburnt charge, which will have more influence for the knocking of the SI engine. Increasing the speed of the spark ignition engine will increase the tendency of knocking, decrease the tendency of knocking, does not affect the knocking. So increase the tendency of knocking. Desirable characteristics of common chamber of IC engine to avoid knock: small bore, short ratio of flame path to bore, absence of hard surfaces in the end region of the gas, all the above. So desirable characteristics of combustion chamber of SI engine to avoid knocking: it should be smaller bore, shorter ratio of flame path to bore diameter, absence of the hard surface, so all the above. Decreasing the temperature of cooling water in the spark ignition engine will increase the tendency of knocking, decrease the tendency of knocking, does not affect the knocking, none of the above. Decreasing temperature of cooling water will decrease the tendency of knocking. So the questions, it is only to understand. And so these are the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. You can refer other books mentioned here for more information on the topic. Thank you for watching. You please post comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. And you subscribe to YouTube video. I have more than 160 YouTube video on the thermal engineering subject, like thermodynamics, heat and mass transfer, thermal engineering, which will be useful for your examination. And you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp for any doubt. I will sincerely answer. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again.